Yo, Trav here, back for another match of with Ninja Bear here. This is an interesting line where you can lead with Serum Visions to be more likely to hit your land drop, or you can play the more high variance play of Delver on turn one, and we can redecide in the next turn. This way, okay, well, Tron is popular today. Not the best starting draw. Yeah, so we're probably against actual Tron this time and not Eggs Tron. Tron of the day, I suppose. So here we could get things set up with Serum Visions to make sure that we're ready to remand. Jeez, bottom both of these. I bottomed both of those because we actually want to land Orgataxian Probe. Really, we want to land more than anything. So see what the opponent has. If they have a second Tron and then Expedition Map for the third, we're probably just going to be too slow this game. But who knows? We'll see what we draw. Maybe our Delver flips. And or we draw Sylvan Scrying. Okay. Nice line by the opponent, leaving up Expedition Map. Really needing to flip Delver and or draw a land here. Vapor Snag, at least we're flipping. Although we don't have. I mean, leaving the Serum Visions may have been correct. We could have flipped the Serum Visions and then hit a land on the same turn. So I think the Serum. Yeah, keeping Serum Visions actually would have been better than putting it on the bottom. But it's worked out okay. Red Pyroclasm. Yep. Gataxian Probe. See how deep we're in the hole here. Chromatic Star, Karn Liberated. Ancient Stirrings. Well, we still haven't drawn a land, so Serum Visions would have helped with that. But some games, this happens. Yeah, in the last game, I made a note. Sometimes you take a line and it changes the percentage. So, for instance, if you change this deck from 20 lands to 21 lands, I'm not certain that the total win percentage would change, but you would flood slightly more. You would lose to flood slightly more and lose to screw. So, I'm going to concede. Lose to screw slightly less. Yeah, I'm just going to scoop out of this. There's Karn and the opponent's at 16. Similarly, you can cut a land and just change the proportion of your losses. Definitely want Remand. Liking Spell Pierce. Mixed on a Null. Liking Vendilion Click, Spellstutter Sprite. Vapor Snag does nothing unless it hits a Worm Coil. Keep with just the two Vendilion clicks. Boomerang can be good. Just bouncing a land. I have too many cards. Yeah, I'm not gonna go with the Anul. I'm gonna trim the Serum Visions again and not play Boomerang. Boomerang shouldn't really be in the sideboard if I'm not bringing it in here. All right, we're back here for game two, and this is a pretty decent starter. We can Spell Pierce, whatever the first play is, probably. We'll see what the Gataxian Probe yields. Yeah, so I mean, statistically, statistics can be indifferent to preference, right? This is what I've been thinking about. There's not always correct. There's not the opponent mulliganed a bunch. Nice. There's frequently not a correct line. There's lines that will produce similar results. For instance, you could submit a mono red burn deck, or you could play with an elf deck, and one isn't correct. So the way that we treat giving feedback on decks, I think that we need to be really. We don't need to be. We ought to be conscious of preference at all times. Like, right? Cast this again. Karn. So the opponent's draw is pretty bad. Our draw is pretty bad as well. I'm going to Snapcaster Gitaxian Probe to draw a card again. Playing Spell Pierce. Saving it for another Spell Pierce would be fine, but the opponent's not on pace to necessarily play anything anyways. In this way, we can, say, draw Ninja of the Deep Hours. Yeah, so when we're giving feedback on decks, I'm going to counter it. This could be a waste of a Spell Pierce, but if the opponent completes their Tron, they can Karn through Spell Pierce anyways, so. They draw a red source, they can Pyroclasm as well, so. Draw a card. Disrupting Shoal. That's a good one. Having drawn the Disrupting Shoal, I'm going to go for a Delver here. Because we can, even if the opponent draws red, we can counter it. Almost rooting for them to draw a red source. So, they can play a Karn. Which is pretty good. But it's not actually that problematic at all. We can just ignore it, potentially. Well, Island, that's not true. So what do we have here? We have a Snapcaster Mage on Spell Pierce. Opponent 14. Ninja's attacking the opponent because we want that card draw. And then we do need to go after the Karn. Draw a card here. Cryptic Command, that's a good one. So we could use it somehow in some way to bounce the Karn. Make the opponent replay it. Maybe the opponent plays a spell before Karn and we can counterbounce. It's not so bad anyways. If they minus three on our creature, we can just add a Snapcaster Mage. End of the turn. And finish the Karn off. The opponent's in a precarious position. Karn is really good. When there's few that's fine. When there's few permanents on the board. Forest. Sylvan Scrying. Let's recheck what the opponent was holding. I believe there's a second Karn. There's another Karn. So say that we Disrupting Shoal this. And they go for another Karn. I think that I'm going to let that resolve. To keep up Cryptic Command for the second Karn. If the opponent plays another Karn, they can exile the Delver, and we're not going to have a chance to kill the Karn. But right now, we can kill the Karn by either playing Snapcaster end of turn, or flipping off Delver. So we can let Sylvan Scrying resolve, and we should be able to counter. Play two counters next turn. Disrupting Shoal Snapcaster for the Pyroclasm. If we need to, see we have options here. Cryptic Command, counterbounce. Okay. Now we're in an interesting position. We can Snapcaster to be sure to kill the Karn Liberated. But then we won't necessarily be able to play Cryptic Command and Disrupting Shoal in the same turn. So I'm going to roll the dice a little bit. It's not even Vendilion Click. It's not even rolling the dice so much because if the opponent can only plus Karn, all it's doing is buying time, which is good for certain. Okay, we could Vendilion Click here. Not going to do it. With only the 6 mana. Yeah, we can exile this island, say, which would potentially be useful next turn. But if we ever flip the Delver, or next turn if we flip the Delver, we still have a chance. Okay, gonna Disrupting Shoal with the Snapcaster Mage. This way we still have Cryptic Command up. And if the opponent doesn't play anything worth crypticking, we can Vendilion Click end of the turn. End of the turn. Vendilion Click. So now we can definitely get Karn off, and we have Cryptic Command. Look at the opponents. We can Cryptic Command our counterbounce our Snapcaster even. Karn Pyroclasm. Well, that's pretty annoying. I'm gonna put the Pyroclasm on the bottom. It's because the Karn takes more mana to play. We could leave both, but I would rather take one of these because we have a counter spell for the other. Hope to flip. Finally, nice. Okay, so now we have some serious beatdown. Check the opponent's hand, see what they just drew. Oh, stone. Yikes, that's tough. So, 3, 6, 7, 8. We should just ignore the Karn at this point. Attack the opponent. So say that we attack the opponent for 8, put them to 4, they can minus Karn, exiling 1. Then we can counter. Just counter the O Stone. The opponent. Interesting. 6. So say that we attack the opponent with all. The worst that can go wrong is the opponent minuses the Karn, plays an O Stone, which we have to counter draw. And then plays another Karn, minuses that. And we still have a creature left to kill the Karn, and we'll be ahead. And depending on what we draw, and we can actually play the Delver and just counter the O Stone. Karn can resolve. Karn is fine. So the opponent. Oh, well, this is. Yeah, that. It's pretty horrendously bad. Because the opponent can take this line. Keeping the Delver would have been good. What we can do is bounce the Snapcaster, draw a card. We could also bounce a land, but that wouldn't solve things. Bouncing the Snapcaster seems fine, because then we'll have Snapcaster Cryptic. The opponent is going to have to O Stone, removing their own Karn. And they're not going to have enough mana left over to play another Karn. So we'll be able to. So we should be advantaged with the opponent at 4 life still. Pretty fascinating match, really. Okay, so I guess the opponent wants to see our Delver flip. Snapcaster Mage. Another Snapcaster is a good draw. Okay, so we can swing all out at the opponent with our team of blue creatures. O Stone goes off. Karn is gone. We have Snapcaster Cryptic. With six islands, so we're in decent position, but the opponent has three cards, so O Stone. The opponent has. I guess that's fine because we do want to leave Cryptic up for the Karn. So we can play Snapcaster end of turn. And we could target a Cryptic, but want to leave it in the graveyard. The Snapcaster is just a beatdown component. Yeah. 2 turns ago, I guess I didn't account for everything, which is hard to do. playing the delver from the hand really changed things. Okay, the opponent seems to be going for the O stone now. So they know about one Snapcaster, they may not know about this other one. So hopefully they just walk their card out here. And then we can counter it and put pressure on. I'm definitely concerned about. Yeah, Relic of Progenitus is really bad for us. Because it exiles our cryptic command. We could play Disrupting Shoal. And then what would happen? The opponent's gonna have 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 mana, so they could. Yeah, this is bad. Snapcaster Cryptic this, I guess, and then just hope to somehow grind through Karn. We just need to get value while we can. And that window's about to close. This match has been counter target spell. Is that what we want to do? Or we could bounce a land. Bouncing a land doesn't seem like it will do much of anything. Bouncing our own Cryptic will just give us. Or we could bounce our own Snapcaster. I don't like that. I want the opponent to have to -3 our Snapcaster. Counter target spell, draw a card. And then we just have to hope that the cards that we draw off the Cryptic and for the next turn are really good. Mutavault's not bad with the opponent at 4 life. So Karn resolves, which is not good for us. Phantasmal Bear. However, we can threaten lethal here. So the opponent may need to minus their Karn. But that might not work depending on if they have a Pyroclasm or a Ghost Quarter. Yeah, this game is slipping more and more, but if we draw another creature here, interesting. I just clicked through using Mutavault. The opponent has Ghost Quarter for it, though. So that was a mistake because we needed to make them use the Ghost Quarter so we could Cryptic to bounce the Mutavault and replay it. So I screwed the pooch just now. So we need to readjust for a new plan. Yeah, that was super bad. So the opponent's gonna have to minus to kill the Phantasmal Bear. And then. I guess we'll. Could bounce the Karn. Just past the turn, we can't really bounce any of our own permanents because it'll get Ghost Quartered, which would fizzle the spell. So that was just a mistake. I played it out in my head, but counter target spell, draw a card. We might as well, we're not getting value out of bouncing. And maybe we can draw another creature here. Serum Visions is not horrendously bad, but we're definitely in a tough spot. Whereas we would have been in a good spot because we would have won, actually, if I had not made that mistake. With the opponent at 2 life, Spellstarter Sprite's kind of interesting. Put this on the bottom, put this on top. Minge of Deep Hours for the win. See if the opponent lets us attack with it. Nope. Tap it for mana. Get an island from the deal. I really want to win this game. Don't necessarily deserve it because of how I played it. So we can play the ninja with spell stutter up. If we just pass the turn, that's not going to work as well. The opponent has to minus Karn to kill a ninja if they don't top deck gas right now. Target player exiles a card from his hand, his or her hand. Well, Spellstarter Sprite's coming into play. Maybe that means the opponent drew an Ugin the Spirit Dragon. So, yeah, this match was definitely should have been won off of animating the Mutavault. It was complex and nuanced. I don't feel so bad about screwing it up. I mean, I would have liked to play it perfect, but I also like to think that maybe on... Oh, there was other ways as well. That was the one line I'm fixating on, though. Pass the turn. Well, Spellstarter Sprite didn't perform the best. Almost, though. Well, GG's. It was a good match. Well played by the opponent. See y'all in the next one.